Well, here we are at the Come From Away media call, and I've got here Gene Weygandt. How are you?
I'm terrific, and I'm so excited to be here in Sydney. I'm loving it. We've been here a couple of weeks, and I've spent the bulk of my time being a tourist, and I'm just having a ball. I've already made some golf friends and played by the seaside yesterday at Randwick, saw a whale, which was just wonderful for a guy from the Midwest in the United States. We hardly have any oceans there, and even fewer whales. So I'm having a ball here. I'm just having a great time.
Wow. Well, I can honestly, well, my brother's a golf pro, so you've picked a really good course. You're one of them, I can say.
Yeah, I'm the opposite of a golf pro.
What's your handicap?
My swing.
So you're a hacker.
Exactly.
I'm the northeast tip of North America on an island called Newfoundland. There's an airport, and next to it is a town called Gander. Tonight, we honor who's lost, and we also commemorate what we found.
Ensemble cast, but you play a very important role in Come From Away.
It is. Mayor Claude Elliott, the mayor of Gander, Newfoundland, has a little bit different responsibility than some of the other people in the show in terms of telling the story of what happened over those 5 days. But it is a true ensemble piece. There's no one who really stands out among the cast as being, you know, the star or the lead of the show. And we all play several different characters. Some of them are the Ganderites, and some are people from the plains who were stranded there. Much of, I'm not sure how you would measure, of the dialogue and the lyrics of the song are based on interviews, 4,000 hours or something like that of interviews with people who actually experienced this. And it's just an amazing story over and over and over what happened of a lot of people being in distress and a lot of strangers coming to their rescue and just being decent, kind people. And that's a pretty remarkable story.
And I should actually remind audiences that may not know, what is Come From Away about?
Come From Away is about the 38 planes that were grounded on 9/11/2001 in a very small community in Gander, Newfoundland, which is the very northeast tip of North America. There happens to be a large airport there that has kind of fallen into less use these days. Anyway, 38 planes were grounded. About 7,000 people were taken in by this community of 9,000 people. They almost doubled their population in a matter of a few hours that day, and just took all these people in and took care of them physically and emotionally. Great friendships developed among these people. A lot of people's lives were changed that day, and the particular changes that happened to these people, I think, were as profound as any. So often they were surprised by the kindness that was shown them. And it's just a remarkable story.
This musical tells the story of the Gander people and surrounding towns, but also what's called the Come From Aways, which is the Plain people.
Yeah, exactly. And I just love that expression, the Come From Aways, because I'm a Come From Away here in Australia.
You are. So yeah. Tell us where you're from.
I'm from Chicago mostly, but New York partly, and Los Angeles, depending on which decade you pick. But I always think of myself as a Chicagoan, and I have most of my friends there. And
is this the first time you've been playing the role?
It is, in fact, and I love it. I'm just having a great time. We played Melbourne and Brisbane, and the audiences love the show and come back and back and back to see it again and bring their family and friends. And it's just a wonderful opportunity, partly because this show is so unique and remarkable, you know, and I often say to people, you know, and I've been doing this a lot of years, and no matter how good I think the show is, I'll say to people, well, you might like it, you should come and see it. But this one, I say, I absolutely guarantee you're going to love it. I guarantee you will love this show. Everybody does.
Do you remember where you were on September 11?
Absolutely do. Absolutely. I was living in Los Angeles at the time, and my father-in-law phoned up from Chicago and said, turn on the television. And again, it's one of the lines from the show, turn on the TV, turn on the radio. Everybody did that. Mm. And because we had just gotten out of bed, hadn't had a chance to wake up, we couldn't quite understand what was going on. Is this a movie? Is this? And then as it happened, the timing was such that we saw the second plane hit, and then we were really confused by what had happened. But as several hours passed and nothing happened in Los Angeles, I went to an audition, and we were all there kind with our faces doing this, going, should we continue? I have this appointment that I'm supposed to attend, and you know, I don't know what, a dozen or so people were there, and the people conducting the audition, but we spent kind of the day going, what the heck is happening? And it was really, even at just the distance of across that continent, it was tricky to figure out what exactly had happened, and of course everybody was fearful that is there more of this to come? What's going on? You know?
I share a similar story. For us, your 9 o'clock in the morning is our 10:30.
Right, it was middle of the night.
And yeah, so we at the time had late night news, and I watched it, and we had a lot of the footage shown that will never be seen in the light of day again. For the people that woke up in the morning, they just got the reruns, but they never got what we got. So with that in mind, did you find that when you approached this musical and this character, that you had so much heart and so much to give?
Yeah, it feels like an important story to tell. But I'll share with you my experience when I saw the show in New York. And a dear friend of mine from Chicago, Joel Hatch, plays the mayor on Broadway. And I had gone to see the show the night before my audition. And at the end of, near the end of the play, Hannah and Beulah have an exchange. And I don't want to give anything away, but one of the Ganderites and a plain person who became dear, dear friends. But I was standing in the back of the house because there weren't any seats left, and I was just standing watching to try and copy my buddy Joel. And I just shouted, whoa, and burst out crying. But I don't want to scare people away. It's also a very funny, funny show, and it's a very sweet show. There's a couple in the play that, and it's a real story. They met and fell in love and got married.
Oh,
Nick and Diane.
Nick and Diane.
Yeah.
Yes.
And it's just a wonderful, wonderful story about them. And I often think what they must have felt like the first time they heard that number, because a lot of those people have followed this show around the world. They've mm-hmm. seen it in New York. They've seen it. They saw it originally in Melbourne. They traveled to London, the Ganderites and Plain People. And I thought, what must those people think seeing their story told on a Broadway stage?
Well, did you meet them? Because if you opened in Melbourne, I met them. Did you meet the real people?
I did not, because I came to the second Melbourne opening. The gentleman who was playing the role before me decided not to continue, and that's how I wound up here. I had auditioned for them in New York for the North American tour.
Right.
And they called and asked if I would come to Australia.
So have you been screeched in? Because when Melbourne...
I have not.
Oh, because when Melbourne opened, the original Newfounders, the characters that were... the real-life people that inspired the characters turned up to Melbourne, and they performed a screech in for all of the cast. And in the scene where they have the yellow hats,
yep.
Beulah brought special hats, those ones from Newfoundland, and they performed it all. But she said, I'm going back with one less, so someone in the cast has stolen.
Somebody copped their hat. You know they would. They're actors. Come on.
So I've sort of been thinking all this time, because a lot of people don't realize that it was 2019 in Melbourne. We're supposed to be here last year.
Right.
Of course, COVID hit, and that's why we're here in 2021. And a lot of the original Newfoundlanders can't make it. Our borders are closed.
Right. No one can get here. And I'll tell you, I have been for years a long distance motorcyclist, and there's a group that I ride with that goes up to Newfoundland once in a while, and there is a motorcycle rally up there called the Blue Nose Rally, where it's the exact same ceremony. You drink some sort of horrible liquor and kiss a fish, and that's how you're inducted into this particular
I'm disappointed that they're not here, because I remember them saying that they were going to come back for Sydney, which was supposed to be the year after, and they were going to screech in everyone. And
yeah, it would be wonderful. Mm. And I've seen video of them and of some of their visits to the casts of various various companies, and it's really kind of wonderful and great to have that connection. Once in a while, we'll see someone in the audience at bows with a Newfoundland flag.
Really?
Yeah, I've been surprised at how many Newfies we meet here in Australia, and there are lots of them. So, and you can't blame them for coming here. The weather up there is horrible.
On the northeast tip of North America, on an island called Newfoundland, there's an airport, and next to it is a town called Gander. Tonight, we honor what was lost, but we also commemorate what we found.
Nice to be in Orbit.